I just happen to have a loose tooth here, one of my molars. You talked about the Robinsons. Well, I know Randy Moeller and and if I can have an appointment at 2:30. And Curly Robinson, who was the other long lost brother, played today in the NBA. It is so great to be here. I want to first of all salute a gentleman who called me several months ago. Dean Zamorodi, take a bow. I think it was he and Jeff that was their brainchild to honor the Whalers. And I remember our first conversation. He says, we want to honor the 20th year that the team left town. He didn't exactly put it that way, but I thought, what a novel idea. And he said, can you help me try to get a hold of certain players? And told him I'd love to, because I have always had a passion for this community. Right from the days that I originally got a phone call from the late Bill Barnes, who many of you may know, our old marketing director with the team. And in August of 1979, I made one of the greatest decisions of my life, broadcasting games at the University of Wisconsin as I did. He said, would you come out and work with the Hartford Whalers? And it was the best decision my wife and I could have made. You've made so many great friends. Honored to meet all of the great players that are here today and many others that you followed in your days following the Whaler team in the NHL and in the WHA, which preceded me. And it's so good to see everybody here this afternoon. And I thank again the Yard Goats, beautiful facility, for doing this for the Hartford Whalers in memory of this hockey club.